Hi, I'm EvilsVox and welcome to the Intel Streamers Bootcamp. Today I'm going to show you how to set up and stream with XSplit, as well as some neat upcoming things in the XSplit line to keep an eye on. When it comes to getting your content online, XSplit is one of the most widely used programs. In this video, we'll be covering the XSplit Broadcaster and Gamecaster software and what to expect when setting up a stream. For the best results and a dynamic and engaging live stream experience, you'll need a gaming rig, preferably powered by an Intel Core i7 processor, a stable internet connection of course, the content that you want to stream, presumably a game in this situation, a Twitch.tv account, an Intel RealSense camera, as well as XSplit. Let's walk through the main steps to set up a basic stream in XSplit. Head into the XSplit software and add your Twitch account. To do this in Gamecaster, just open the main menu and go to Accounts. Here, you'll want to link XSplit to your Twitch account so you can stream. Log in and give XSplit access to your profile. In XSplit Broadcaster, you need to go to Outputs, set up a new output, and then choose Twitch and log in from there. Next, you want to add any sources that you want to use. Gameplay, webcams, image overlays, and so on. Use Gameplay Capture to capture PC games, Media File for image overlays, and then choose your webcam or capture card from the list of connected video devices. Click the gear next to the volume levels to choose your system audio and microphone audio, and balance the audio levels accordingly. Your game sound should not be louder than your voice. Your voice needs to be clear and present. Head up to your canvas settings and change your resolution and frame rate. For Twitch, you can only stream at a max of 1080p, but for most people, 720p should be what you're aiming at. 60 frames per second is desired for the smoothest possible streaming experience. With an Intel Core i7, streaming 60 FPS is a breeze. To choose your streaming bitrate, first head over to speedtest.net or openspeedtest.com and run a speed test. Keep in mind that your internet connection must also sustain your game and anything else on your network. For a maximum bitrate that your connection can handle, I generally recommend going no further than 75% of your internet's upload speed. However, Twitch can only support a maximum bitrate of 6 megabits per second, so if your internet connection can handle more than that, then your maximum bitrate will be 6. It's worth noting here that 6 megabits per second maximum bitrate includes audio and video. So for your maximum video bitrate, you can go up to 5,840 kilobits per second, and for audio, you can go up to 160 kilobits per second. XSplit does a good job of automatically optimizing the settings for Twitch, but go ahead and make sure that the keyframe interval is set to 2 and that the video is set to strict CBR, which is constant bitrate, not variable bitrate. Here's a couple quick troubleshooting tips. If you're running a particularly CPU intensive game and the frame rate just is getting lowered by your streaming process, you can switch your streaming encoder to your hardware accelerated encoding with NVIDIA or AMD. Again, this will be slightly lower video quality, but it will help reduce system impact from the streaming process and might speed things up. If you're having trouble getting the XSplit Gamecaster overlay to loop into your games, you may need to disable any extra overlay programs such as NVIDIA Share or Shadowplay, the Xbox DVR built into Windows 10, or even the Steam overlay. If you've come across another problem, leave a comment down below and we might make another video addressing your concerns. For more Intel Streamers Bootcamp videos, check out the links at the end of this video. For a more in-depth XSplit tutorial, get subscribed to my channel. I have a couple videos coming down the pipeline. Check back often for newly released content related to bettering your creator and streaming experience. I'm EvilsVox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and I will see you next time.